Hey everybody, it's Jang here from JANGBRiCKS.com with a look at a LEGO Minecraft Micro World set. This is the end. It came out for the summer 2014 release season. It comes with 440 pieces in total. All of the boxes of the Micro World set series are based on an actual Minecraft block, and this one is based on a block of obsidian. Here is the finished model, the completed thing, built to box specifications and instruction specifications. You can see it's kind of a two-level thing. It is made in exactly the same size and using the same connection standard that they came up with for the very first Kuso-based model, and thus it is compatible with all of the micro worlds they have created to date. This one does give you the four Endermen, and also one single Ender Dragon, which we'll look at up more closely. And it's built in four chunks, so you can take these pieces apart. Here's a look at it from the ground level, so you can see the structure of it underneath a little bit more. They do have the full flat platforms on the bottom. I believe that's mostly for consistency with the other micro worlds. It's just kind of part of the standard. Not the most realistic thing there to have the big flat square surface on the top and then a big flat square surface on the bottom, but I think they were doing their best to kind of go between the way that the end actually spawns in the game or is created in the game and something that will fit in with the other sets. Here's a closer look at the little micro scale Endermen, so you can see how they are built up. The main thing that is kind of the core of them is a 1x1 black brick with studs on two sides. And that's how they attach the 1x2 tiles for the arms. And you do have these printed eye pieces. They give you enough to make five Endermen, actually. They give you six sets of eyes. It's a printed 1x1 plate. So you get one extra. You can make one extra Enderman if you have a few extra pieces. And there's just one Enderman by himself. There's the Ender Dragon, who, as you can see, uses another of the sets of the same eyes with another 1x1 brick printed on one side. And he's got one single joint there at the front so he can move his head up and down at the neck. And he's got wings which can actually be flapped up and down, a nice long tail. And he does come on this transparent stalk that makes it look like he's actually flying. I think this thing is really, really exceptionally well done for its scale. I don't think I could have done better myself. There are different kind of ways of interpreting the look of the Ender Dragon down into, you know, basically the scale and design of LEGO parts, but as things go, I think this is just a really well done version.
Yeah, you can angle the head up, or you can angle the head way down.
There's a look at him a little bit more from above. You can just see kind of the spread and the proportions of them. And he even has little feet kind of approximated right there. Just coming down with the little ExoForce arm, well, hand, I guess. With the mobs removed, let's take another look at the surface here. So this is the perch. So what they're trying to show here is clearly a corner of the end. It's not trying to represent the entire end in kind of a caricature micro kind of scale. So it's, you know, there would be more of this continuing on all around at least two sides of it. The strange thing for me is that the towers are really not arranged in a concentric partial circle around the perch and around the portal back home. So that's a little bit awkward to me. All the ones that I've seen naturally generated have always kind of tried to create a pretty much a circle around there. It's not going to be a perfect one, but pretty close. So a couple of these are pretty far off, I would say. That's a little bit awkward to me. The towers themselves, I think, are done perfectly. The black for obsidian, and then the ender crystals up top are approximated with these purple transparent 1x1 round tiles. I think that's the best you could have done for this scale. It really looks right. It kind of looks like those things would look from a distance. Let me go ahead and show you how these appear when they are pulled apart. So these are just connected, just like the last ones, with Technic pins. I'll allow you to open them up like that. You can also take the individual ones apart. and kind of rearrange them if you like. You can see this is really intended to be showing the truly solid interior of the end, and they tried to get a little bit of texture in there to just break up the monotony so it's not all one color. There they are from the other side. And here's the lower view to show you just the hollowed out parts. Also following with kind of the standard again that they created for the originals, you can take the tops off. It's not very useful for this particular set to be able to take the top bits off because everything is open on the sides. With some of the others, it was good to get light in there when multiple sides were actually mostly covered up, but it's still something that's gonna allow you to swap these different ones back and forth. You can also easily rotate them around if you like, so you can just kind of change the orientation like so.
And if you change stuff around just so, you can kind of start to move towards more of a circle kind of arrangement. Maybe move this closer to the center. I think that's a little bit better, and it's really nice to be able to change the arrangement like that without actually changing any parts. You know, it's really designed to be modular in that way, so that was pretty easy.
Of course, it is Lego, so it's very easy to customize it however you want to make it look more like the versions of the end that you personally have seen. Now for the tough question, the one of color. Did they do the color right? It's a really rough thing because the color of endstone is so strange, so unusual. Technically, it's green. It is green. Different people have different monitor settings, but the actual color itself is a greenish, kind of a greenish beige. And, you know, they've kind of tried to approximate the look of endstone on a different scale with this by mixing in these little bits of dark tan in there to kind of represent the texture, the darker texture color in endstone. So on a higher level, I think it looks good. I think that it was a smart idea to mix together multiple colors, even though, you know, technically all endstone looks the same. So it's kind of a rough thing not being able to put texture into each individual element, each individual Lego piece. Personally, I would have preferred sand green. That's just me. I feel like the light, the normal tan color really should remain reserved just for sand and possibly sandstone. For these sets, I really feel like that's a perfect match there. And bringing this in as the same color for the endstone, personally, I don't think was the best idea. I know it's a rough decision, and I'm sure that plenty of folks would disagree, which is perfectly fine because, like I said, it's just my personal opinion. But feel free to share your opinion. I'm especially interested to hear what folks think about the issue of color, and also, you know, post up what you think about the set in general, especially the actual Minecraft players out there who know firsthand what this ought to look like. Just you know, keep in mind that there are limitations for building with Lego, but still feel free to just share your thoughts if you like this, if you don't like it, if there are specific things that you think are done great, or there are specific things that you think are not done all that well. It's always good to see more feedback from more different perspectives. Thank you for watching this video. Please hit thumbs down or thumbs up on the video, either way, depending upon whether you disliked it or liked it. And stick around for more, because more videos are always on the way from me. Bye for now.